You know, one of the most common comments I get is that, man, this president seems consumed with watching righty media and being on Twitter all the time. And you know what? His schedule gives you guys some basis for your complaints. There's another leak from the White House that gives us another insight. According to 3 months of leaked White House schedules, about 60% of President Trump's time is so-called executive time, a phrase that reportedly covers time for tweeting, phoning friends, and watching TV. Understandably, Sarah Sanders says this is just the president being creative, that he's simply a different kind of president. Nobody's going to argue with that. But for comparison, take a look at this. This is FDR's daily schedule from back in the day. Take a look at this and how much booking there was from 9 o'clock in the morning or so until 11:30 at night. Why? Because the president's got like the hardest job in the world. And you'll certainly hear that from those who have done it. Take a listen.
It's a hard job, and it's difficult.
You know, nothing truly prepares you for the demands of the Oval Office. You can read about it, you can study it, but until you've sat at that desk, you don't know what it's like to manage a global crisis.
I can't even imagine. I can't even imagine the stress and the strain. That's why these men, almost without exception, either prepare like crazy or have people around them who are as prepared as they possibly can be. So as this current president prepares to address you tomorrow night about promises kept, I would remind you that he promised you more and better. He told you he knows how to get things done. Listen.
I promise you that I will work so hard, we're going to get it turned around.
I just want to stay in the White House and work my ass off.
I'm going to be working for you.
He doubled down when he suggested that he'd never go golfing the way that Obama did. He may have even said never at all. And then remember what he said about Hillary Clinton and stamina. Look, we know those were BS arguments when he made them. They were just cheap politics, but they worked at the time. But now that we see his schedule, it seems that the resolute desk, you know what we call this? It's more of a prop for photo ops than anything else, according to the schedule. 60% executive time goes to what has become a disturbing trend with this president, an apparent unwillingness for the difficulties of the job he was elected to do. So when you hear him about wandering out of a key policy meeting with the Speaker of the House, seeing his own intel chiefs say publicly that he's misinformed on global threats, when important parts of his job, like making sure the government is properly staffed, you know, they still have a ton of jobs outstanding, right? You have to ask, who's doing the job of the president? Oftentimes, we know the answers. You remember when the military decided to drop the mother of all bombs, the MOAB, in Afghanistan? Who made the decision? Not people who were elected to do it. So, it is good that someone leaked this because you deserve to know how much of the president's time is about you versus him. When you see giant holes in his schedule and tons of executive time, which, by the way, is officially what I'm going to call fight training and fishing from now on. I used to call it me time. Now it's executive time. Back to what matters. You look at the schedule. You look at no log of who is coming and going at the White House. No reports of his conversations with foreign leaders. You need to know what the president does. It'll give you insight into why he does what he does. Remember, the president works for you.